Hello everyone, this is our seventh lecture of chapter Light, Reflection and Refraction, and the topics I'm going to cover in this session are as follows. Let's try numericals based on refractive index and Snell's law. Question number one, a ray of light in air enters obliquely into water. Does the light ray bends towards the normal or away from the normal? Why? So we have been given a ray of light enters from medium air into medium water. And we know if we compare these two medium, air is rarer. Means the density of air is less than the density of water. Suppose if we draw a normal line, and if we throw a ray of light at an angle I, let this be the point of incidence. Since the ray is passing from rarer medium to denser medium, means the speed of light will going to be decreased when it enters the medium water. Thus, the ray of light will bend towards the normal at an angle R. Question number two. A ray of light is incident from medium air in a certain medium X at an angle of incidence 60 degree. If the angle of refraction be 45 degree, calculate the refractive index of the medium X. So we have been given that a ray of light enters from medium air into medium X and the angle of incidence I is given 60 degree and the angle of refraction R is given 45 degree and we are supposed to calculate the refractive index of medium X. According to Snell's law, the refractive index of medium X with respect to medium air can be written as the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction. So we can write nx, that is the refractive index of medium x with respect to medium air, is equals to the ratio of sine of 60 degree. 60 degree is the angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction. And angle of refraction is 45 degree. Using trigonometric table, we can find the value of sine 60 and sine 45. The value of sine 60 is root 3 by 2. And the value of sine 45 is 1 by root. On solving, the refractive index of medium X with respect to medium air is given by 1.22. Question number 3. Light enters from air to glass having refractive index 1.50. What is the speed of light in the glass? The speed of light in vacuum is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So we have been given that a ray of light enters from medium air into medium glass. Let the speed of light in medium air be V air and the speed of light in medium glass be V of D. We are assuming the speed of light in air or vacuum are same. From the relation of refractive index, we can write refractive index of medium glass with respect to medium air is equal to speed of light in medium air divided by speed of light in medium glass. And the refractive index of medium glass with respect to medium air is given to us 1.50. So on substituting, velocity of light in air is same as velocity of light in vacuum. So we can write here 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second divided by speed of light in glass. So on solving, the speed of light in medium glass comes out to be 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So we find that when a ray of light enters from medium air to medium glass, its speed decreases since The medium glass is denser than medium air or medium vacuum. Question number 4. The speed of light in water is 2.25 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. If the speed of light in vacuum be 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, calculate the refractive index of water. So we have been given the speed of light in medium water is 2.25 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, whereas the speed of light in vacuum is given 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. And we are supposed to calculate the refractive index of medium water with respect to medium vacuum. So NWV represents the refractive index of medium water with respect to medium vacuum. So we know the formula for refractive index of medium water with respect to medium vacuum is given by speed of light in medium vacuum divided by the speed of light in medium water. On substituting the values, the refractive index of medium water with respect to medium vacuum comes out to be 4/3. Question number 5. The refractive index of diamond is 2.42. What is the meaning of this statement? So here we have been given the absolute refractive index of diamond. Absolute refractive index means the refractive index of diamond with respect to vacuum or air. From the formula of refractive index, we can write refractive index of diamond with respect to vacuum as speed of light in medium vacuum or medium air divided by speed of light in medium diamond. The absolute refractive index of diamond is given 2.42. We can write this relation as speed of light in medium diamond is equals to speed of light in vacuum divided by 2.42. From this relation we can see the speed of light in diamond is decreases to 1/2.42 times the speed of light in vacuum. And we can also calculate the speed of light in diamond by substituting the speed of light in vacuum. You know, the speed of light in vacuum is given as 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. On solving, the speed of light in diamond comes out to be 1.24 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. This is the speed of light in diamond when it enters from medium air. Next we have effects of reflection. Why coin appears to be raised when it is placed in water? Let this be the actual position of coin and this be the apparent position when viewed from outside the tank. Let these are the two rays which are originating from the coin and they are moving from medium water into medium air, and we know water medium is more denser as compared to medium air. And when these rays coming out from water, it will bend away from the normal. If we draw normal here, then we can see that these two rays which are coming out of the water will bend away from the normal. And these rays are reaching towards the eye. When our eye trace these rays back to a point, then they appear to meet at this point. So this gives the apparent position of the coin. This is the apparent position of the coin. This is how coin appears to be raised when placed under water. Why pencil or stick partially immersed in water appears to be bent? Next we have spherical lenses. Spherical lenses are of two types, convex lens and concave lens. Convex lenses are thicker at the middle and thinner at the edges. A convex lens is a converging lens, that is, when parallel rays of light pass through a convex lens, the refracted rays converge at one point called the principal focus. Convex lenses can form either real or virtual images, and the image form can be magnified, diminished, or of same size. Whereas a concave lens is thinner at its center than at its edges. It is a diverging lens, meaning that it spread out the light rays that have been refracted through it. Concave lens can only form virtual and diminished image. I am assigning you this worksheet, which is based on today's lecture. Thank you.